our viewers. My name is Stephen Nganga Njoroge, and I love Jesus Christ as my personal savior. I worship in PCA, Bagadi Parish, and this service is being broadcasted from PCA, Okatarogai. Our theme today is, why do you doubt? Why do you doubt the power of the Lord? Why do you doubt Jesus? In this era of COVID-19, why are you doubting? We are going to read from the book of Matthew, chapter 14. We read from verse 26 to 31. When the disciples saw Jesus walking on the lake, they were terrified. "It is a ghost," they said, and cried out in fear. But Jesus immediately said to them, "Take courage, it is I, don't be afraid." "Lord, if it is you," Peter replied, "tell me to come to you on the water." "Come," Jesus said. Then Peter got down out of the boat, walked on the water, and came toward Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was afraid and, beginning to sink, cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately Jesus reached out his hand and caught him. "You of little faith," he said, "why did you doubt?" Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name, we give you all the glory and honor for who you are and what you have done in our life. Help us not to doubt you. You have been working with us in our spiritual life, in our physical life. You are reliable. You love us. Even this time of COVID-19 era, our Heavenly Father, we will still continue having faith in you. We will not doubt you. Help us not to doubt you. In Jesus' name, we pray and believe. Amen. As we have read, the text we have read from the book of Matthew, we have read a text where, after Jesus fed the 5,000 men, Jesus, as usual, went to pray in the mountain. And the following day, Jesus met his disciples. His disciples were in the lake, and suddenly, the disciples of Jesus Christ saw him walking on the water. And then they got astonished and said, "This must be a ghost." These disciples of Jesus Christ, they had walked with Jesus. They had seen Jesus performing miracles. They had seen Jesus turning water into wine. They had seen Jesus casting demons. They had seen Jesus healing people. They had seen Jesus even healing the blind and cripples walking through his name. But this time, they saw a ghost. They doubted Jesus. They saw a ghost. But Jesus said, "Don't worry, I am the one." And Peter said, "If you are the one, then let me come." And here we see, when Peter started walking toward Jesus, there was a wind and waves such that Peter started sinking. And he called at the name of Jesus. And when he called the name of Jesus, Jesus got hold of his heart and he said, "Why are you of little faith?" And now in the beginning, let's go back to where Jesus was walking over the water. They called Jesus, they thought it was a ghost. It is not a wonder. As a faithful Christian, as a believer, a time comes when people you walk together, when they see your faith, they doubt who you believe in. Sometimes we have heard people being called names. Christians sometimes are called names. We have heard of Christians being called a thief simply because they are blessed, they are doing marvelous, but some people doubt our God. They see a thief. We have seen some Christians being called conmen, and we have seen others being called witchcraft because of the things they are doing through the power of God. We have also seen others being called prostitute, others being called, they are told that they hate people when they don't hate people. If Jesus was called names, you will also be called names as a believer. But trust in Jesus, because Jesus will never leave you. And then we have this person called Peter. And you know Peter? Peter was one of the three innermost friends or disciples of Jesus Christ. The three friends, innermost friends or disciples of Jesus Christ, innermost, we had Peter, John, and James. And you see here, Peter saying, "Jesus, if you are the one, let me come." See the word "if." The word "if" is talking about doubt. Jesus, if you are the one, let me come. And Jesus told him, "Come." And here the Bible says, as Peter started walking toward Jesus, there was a wind, a strong wind, such that there were waves, and Jesus started, and Peter started sinking. And here, as Christians, in this journey of faith, let me assure to you that we are not immune to life challenges. As Christian, Jesus did not tell us that we will not be going through challenges because we are Christians or because we are born again. But Jesus promised to us, whenever we will be going through challenges, Jesus will be with us. Jesus will be helping us to overcome the challenges. We have several challenges. In this era of COVID-19, there are so many challenges which are affecting both the believers and non-believers. Most of the people have been suspended from work. Others have gone for unpaid leave. Actually, there are some people, even they are almost bankrupt, because we are in a time when it is spreading, when I don't know when you will be paid next. Others have started even spending school fees for their children, because we are comparing. Now, am I going to spare school fees for my children and my children die of hunger? It's better we use school fees, by the time children will go back to school, our God will provide. It is a difficult time. But those who trust in Jesus, they will never regret, because Jesus will always be with us. Because Jesus overcame, we will also be overcoming. Let me tell you, my fellow brethren, sometimes God allows some situations. Sometimes God allows Christians to go through difficult situations so that we can be able to see his power over that situation. Sometimes you can go through a situation of lacking so that Jesus can provide, so that you can be able to see the power of God to provide. Sometimes we can go through the challenges of getting sick so that Jesus can heal us, so that we can be able to see the power of healing in Jesus' name. There are some situations we go through so that God can manifest his power to us. And now here, we see, when Peter started walking through the water, or over the water, he started sinking. And the good thing with Peter is he knew Jesus as his savior. Jesus is a savior. And he called to that mighty name of Jesus. And Jesus got hold of his heart. And so he never sank. My dear brethren, at times as Christians, our lives start sinking. This COVID-19 virus has made many situations to the people of the world to start sinking. The world economy have started sinking. Quite a number of businesses have started sinking. Actually, another day, I was discussing with my wife, and as I was going through this town here, we found most of the business, most of the buildings have been closed. Businesses have started sinking. Sometimes even education have started sinking. Some of our children were in school on March, but now they are at home. They are not able to study. Others, they have no access to study through online. Because of this COVID-19, we are hearing of peace in the family sinking. We are being told by through the research that quite a number of people, there's domestic violence, the number of domestic violence is increasing. This is because peace in the family has started sinking. Some people has started becoming bankrupt because of COVID-19. We need God in our life. Peter knew his power, his salvation was in Jesus. And this Jesus do not change. The way he was yesterday is the way he is today, and he will also be tomorrow. Don't doubt, my dear brothers and sisters. Doubt is the greatest hindrances to prayers, miracles, wonders, and signs. in the heart of a believer. Let us not. The Lord who started with us will also finish with us. It doesn't matter what we are going to go through. I'm telling you, even after COVID-19, our faith will be stronger. Because our God will take us through. What God has started in our life, He has to finish. If God has given you a wife or a husband, why doubt of children? If God has given you a fiancé, why doubt of dowry? If God has given you a successful wedding, why doubt of settling? If God has given you a family, why doubt of feeding them? If God has given you a plot, why doubt of building? If God has given you a capital, why do you doubt of investing? If God has given you the first business, why don't you doubt starting the second business? If God has given you a job, why doubt of saving? If God has enabled you to go through college, why do you doubt of landing a job? If God has started, if you have studied very hard in your exam, why doubt of passing exam? If you are an employee, why do you doubt of being an employer one day? If you operate a retail shop, why doubt of operating a horse? If you are sick, why doubt of getting healed? Through the 39 stripes that Jesus was beaten at the cross of Calvary. If you have been a student, why doubt of being a lecturer one time? If you are poor, why doubt of becoming rich? If your firstborn went through secondary, colleges to university, why doubt of your lastborn going to university? My dear brothers and sisters, let us not doubt the power of God. He is with us. In the Bible, in the Old Testament and the New Testament, we have seen scenario or have seen people who doubted. We have John the Baptist in Luke chapter 7, verse 18 to 23. Sometimes when he heard about Jesus Christ, that when he was imprisoned, he sent his disciples to go and see whether Jesus is the one who was promised. But when his disciples went and found Jesus, Jesus told him, go and tell John the Baptist what you have seen. Jesus was preaching, he was performing miracles. He was at time doubting. Think of Sarah, the wife of Abraham, in Genesis chapter 18, 9 to 14. Sometimes when Sarah was told by God that by an angel, she would have a son. Because of her age, she almost doubted. Actually, even Abraham, her husband, almost doubted. But even having a son with Hagar, Abraham having a son with Hagar, but Jesus, God told Abraham, I will bless you from the womb of Sarah. Sarah, at one time. Zachariah, think of Zachariah, a priest and the father of John the Baptist. When he was told that he'll have a baby son, in Luke chapter 1, verse 18, he doubted and became a dumb till when he got the baby son. What about Thomas? Thomas was one of the disciples of Jesus Christ. And Thomas, at one time, he doubted. He doubted. After Jesus resurrected, he doubted whether he was the little Jesus. Unless when Jesus showed him scars, this is when he believed. Let us not doubt. We have walked long way with our Lord Jesus Christ. He has saved us. He has blessed us with many things in our life. The same Jesus will walk with us during COVID-19 and even during post-COVID-19 era. May God bless you.